Hello, and welcome back to Brainwave Scanner Reviews. Today, we are going to look at Specialist Altitude from the 2009 Assault on Cobra Island box set. Now, before we get into anything else, I need to clear something up. Yes, if you look at his file card, he is a variant of Freefall, but just look at him. He is clearly meant to be Ripcord. I don't know why they didn't make him Ripcord, but he is clearly meant to be the modern version of the 1983 design of Ripcord. That is who he is to me, and that is who I am going to be comparing him to. So, for all intents and purposes, he is Ripcord. So, starting from the top, if you you can see, we'll get into the head later, but he doesn't quite have the red hair that the original Ripcord has, and he also looks older. He is wearing this pretty good paratrooper suit. I do have to say, this is a Kitbash figure, and, you know, Hasbro patented Kitbash. There is nothing new here. But I think they did a good job choosing parts to look like a paratrooper suit. And they did a really good job matching the original. As you can see, like the original, he's wearing this long sleeve shirt with collar, two pockets on the chest, and elasticized cuffs on the sleeves. He's wearing black gloves, just like the original. The original has some of the web gear molded onto its waist piece. Here it's part of this separate piece that does not come off, that holds the parachute. On the original, the parachute was a removable accessory. As on the original, we have pouches on each leg and black boots. And as on the original, we have this olive green, olive drab color with the brighter green camouflage. So, overall, it is a really good match for the original, but for one glaring fault. That would be the head. They reused the head for whatever reason from the Red Star figure, and while it works great for Red Star because it looks very Russian, very kind of beaten and a little older, as Red Star should be as an officer, it does not work for Ripcord. Ripcord should not look like a 45-year-old man, so I have no idea why they chose this head. But otherwise, like I said, you can't go wrong if you want a vintage-inspired Ripcord for your collection. So, for scores, for fidelity to original, I have to give him an 8, just because of that head. That head knocks down 2 points. Otherwise, it would be a 10 out of 10. For quality, I give him an 8. Some of the parts are a little older. You know, all of these are 25th anniversary parts, so they're not the best in terms of articulation, but they're all sculpted well. They work well. It looks good for Ripcord. The paint is good. Again, well matched to the original Ripcord. Maybe a little brighter, but good. And the details are good. And then, so for the accessories, we have four, because of the parachute that doesn't come off. But then we have this oxygen mask, the helmet that it attaches to, and this rifle. For their fidelity, I give them a 9, because this is what vintage Ripcord came with. Parachute, oxygen mask, helmet, and rifle. The rifle is not an exact match for the original, and that's okay. The helmet and oxygen mask look good, but there is a couple of problems. One is they don't fit together all that well, and they don't fit him that well because they were originally for Blowtorch. The other problem is that the hose has nothing to plug into like the vintage one did. It had a port on the chest, or the parachute. So, for fidelity, I give them a 9. For quality, I give them an 8. Again, because that helmet is a little finicky, doesn't fit the best, and it doesn't plug in. And so for their average is an 8.5. Overall, for Ripcord's average, is an 8.5. He's a very good, almost great figure, except for that head. In fact, when I display him, I never take the helmet off. He always has it on, because it just does not work for me. But otherwise, he's a great figure, If you want a vintage-inspired ripcord for your collection, he is perfect for that. All right, I'll see you next time.